Hi everyone, Drini here, and welcome to my channel. So with Bitcoin and the rest of the markets being very stagnant this week, even that is not going to stop us from doing Sunday Shorts, where we do a weekly roundup of all the cryptos we covered this week. So today, we're going to relook at Star Atlas, Sandbox, Chain Guardians, and Wonderhero. Now, before I dive in, if you notice, we haven't really been covering a lot of gaming tokens in detail. That is because if I don't talk about that particular token throughout the week, it means whatever technical analysis that we've did is still very much relevant for that particular gaming crypto. So if you're looking for an update, just rewatch the old videos and you would see what needs to be done. And let's dive in. So I have POLIS here, and the last time that we reviewed POLIS, we did specify that this particular break-in structure has a Fibonacci retracement model, but it's in reverse. So if we overlay the Fibonacci that we did before, as you can see here, you may be wondering, how can we be so overextended from the EMAs right here, but we're not moving up to catch up with it? And the Fibonacci retracement is the reason why. If you notice, we keep hitting our head. So once we broke through this 1618, we kept hitting our head on the 1618 of $5.16 as resistance. So then when Bitcoin further capitulated for this week, then we fell through another level of Fibonacci retracement, and now we are seeing resistance now on this 2 level right here of around $4.22. So the key thing for POLIS is really follow the Fibonacci. If we fall down further of this $3.66, then this could be a buying opportunity. Otherwise, if we just hang out around here in this area, then pretty much this is still within DCA territory. And let's move on. So I have Atlas here. If you notice, Atlas is actually nearing this historical floor right here of around 7 cents. If we overlay the Fibonacci from before, once again, the story of Atlas and POLIS are very similar. They are adhering to the Fibonacci downtrend, and the structure is in reverse. So right now, the moment we broke through this 1.272, we tried hanging on to the 1.272. However, we broke through the downside right here, and now we are facing this 8 cents as resistance. We tried to rally past here, but we failed, and now we're sort of hovering between the 1414 and the 1618 right here. And let's move on. So I have the Sandbox token right here, and if you notice, the Sandbox token throughout this week didn't really do anything. So in our last video, we did specify that we are officially now on an ABC correction right here. Because we failed to break into the structure right here, we are still in the middle of a C wave right here. So both on a daily time frame as well as on a weekly time frame, we are undergoing a correction because this particular wave right here is the wave 4 of a much more massive Elliott wave structure that began in January of 2021. So moving forward for Sand, once again, we are in C waves, DCA accordingly. And let's move on. So the story of Chain Guardians was really falling through this 82 cent support right here. In our last video, we did identify certain support structures moving forward. Because we've fallen through this range right here, we are now playing within this particular zone. The good thing about Chain Guardians so far is at least we are just hovering between the 59 cent area and the 81 cent area right here. So our last video, and in terms of what needs to be done moving forward, is still applicable. If you believe in Chain Guardians, this is pretty much DCA territory right here. But if you want to maximize your returns, then if it hits this 59 cents support level right here, then this is pretty much a buying opportunity. Otherwise, it's the 51 cents. Otherwise, it's the 43 cents. Etc. etc. It's very important for this downtrend to spread out your buys. And finally, we have Wonderhero right here. And the good thing about Wonderhero is because of the game launch, after falling below this key support level of $2.60, we have since rallied back up. But we are starting to see signs that people are starting to consolidate or are starting to profit out of this particular game launch hype right here. So moving forward, after the launch tomorrow, I won't be surprised if we undergo something like this where we can actually break through the structure again and potentially test it like this. And as long as the Bitcoin markets remain weak, then expect that this particular area is the one that we will hang out before our subsequent continuation to the upside. Either way, for all of the gaming cryptos that we covered this week, also across all gaming cryptos so far, it's really pick and choose your own project because everything is in DCA mode. Everything is in an accumulation phase. If you like that video, hit like and subscribe, hit the notification bell. Also, let me know what you think in the comments. Do you want me to make a video about your favorite gaming crypto? Be a Patreon subscriber so you can request for it. Being a Patreon subscriber helps keep the channel sponsor, shill, and moonboy free. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.